Good afternoon all. Today we will discuss about application of statistics in research, population and experimental planning. Okay, so first of all, what is statistics? Statistics is a grammar of science according to Carl Pearson and another scientist Ernest Rutherford. He given, if your experiment needs statistics, you ought to have done a better experiment. Okay, then different scientists like Davidian and Lois in 2012 and Dobje in Dobje Y in 2006, the Oxford Dictionary of Statistical Terms given a different two terms. So these terms already discussed in our previous class, like science is like statistics is a science of learning from data, measuring, controlling, and componenting. Then we can say, the statistics is the statistics of collection, analysis, interpretations, and presentation of and organizations of the data. Okay. Then what are the interrelationship between three basic statistics, like applied statistics, second is theoretical statistics, and another is mathematical statistics. What are the interrelationship? This means what is applied statistics? Applied statistics means this is a descriptive type of statistics, which is, and we can say what is theoretical statistics. Theoretical statistics means the all concept are related to logical arguments. Means this is a theoretical portions and mathematical statistics. So what is mathematical statistics? It contains manipulations of probability distributions like. And most important examples of mathematical statistics is design of experiment. These topics already covered in over my previous class. Okay, design of experiment, we also called as experimental designs. And these are the different roles. What are the provided? Suppose knowledge of statistics provide necessary tools as a conceptual conceptual and foundations is the quantitative reasoning. To extract information and statistical methods and analysis are often used to communicate research findings and to support of the hypothesis of the different types and different types of important. So now our topic is start with statistics in scientific research. So what are the role, what are the applications of the statistics in the scientific research? So this is a flow chart. This is a flow chart for the understanding how we can. Suppose we plan for a experiment. So what are the need of experiment? What are the objective of your experiment? And what are the variables of your experiment? And how you perform your experiment? What are the acts of your result? And how to present your reports for final? So first topic is need for the experiment. What are the needs for experiment? So we design experiments to answer research questions. First is experiments. So experiments used to control sources of variation, detect outliers. Then data, visualize the data, analyze the data, then statistical model. Then give to knowledge. What is knowledge? Knowledge means interpretations of the data, interpretations of the results, interpretations after the formatting of the analysis of the data. Then last one is understanding. How we understand and can make a decisions, means make scientifically sound decisions and communicate them. So this is a solve, how to solve your problem and make a decision. This is a flow chart of your experiment. Then what are the important roles? Statistics play vital role in researchers. For example, statistics can use data collection, then analysis, then interpretations. These are repetitions of the previous study, just repetitions. What are the statistics provide platform to research to how your research is either considered sample, whole populations, then technique used to collection of data. What are the measure of central tendency? These topics also covered by different. Then statistical methods. So what are the statistical methods? And analysis of open use communicate. And most important is researchers are also consumers of research to understand statistics to that can inform, evaluate, and credibility of usefulness of the informations. Okay, so what type of decision you can take in case of experimental design, in case of your experimental plan of experimental. Then most one important thing is statistics is very important when it comes to conclusion of the research. How you conclude your research after completion of the your research program. Then in this aspect, the major purposes of the statistics are help understanding the desirable phenomena. And in our word, helps to draw reliable conclusion about the those phenomena. Ki how you concluded the result and how you after take, suppose you take a suppose you carried out your experiment in a field conditions yeah in a lab conditions, after the taking of different types of data, you should take data analysis by using different softwares and different techniques. And after data analysis, how you represent your data, how you interpret your results. So this makes a your valid summary and valid conclusions of your research. So describe the importance of statistics in different field of study. What are the importance here? First is, statistics has important role in determining the existing positions of per capita income, of employment, versus population growth rate, then housing, then schooling, medical facility, etc. in our country. And now there are various applications, there are various importance. There are various importance which involve in directly and indirectly to, and we can say these are correlated to completely with statistics. Suppose we study in commerce, then the all types of data which is given in the term of conditions of like demand supply data, this all needs a statistical method. Suppose in case of trade, in case of physics, chemistry, economics, mathematics, biology, are all sciences. Like information technology, these are so applications of statistics is very wide. Then, okay, the specificities of the involved to apply the statistical theory to methods to various disciplines. So there are different fields or applications of statistics. Some of those, what are the applications? Suppose in case of astrostatistics, is a discipline that applies statistical analysis to understand astronomical data. Suppose we find different types of astronomical data and how we concluded them and how we take different types of results from their valid data from the raw data of the particular region, the particular environment. Then biostatics, same things. Biostatics is a branch of biology that studies biological phenomena and observation by means of statistical analysis and include medical statistics. Same in case of eco means econometrics, means the metrics data of economics. Means it is a branch of economics that applies statistical method to empirical study of economical theory and relationships. Okay, then business and analytics, same, this is related to our business purpose or business point of view. Then environmental statistics. What is environmental statistics? Is a application of statistics. What are the applications? Most application is statistical method to environmental science. These have like weather data, like climate data, air and water quality data are included as a study under the plant and animal populations, etc. Then statistical mechanics is a applications of probability theory, which includes mathematical tools for dealing with large populations. What are the statistical mechanics? Suppose you want to analysis a large number of data, then we can use these types of mechanics for taking a valid conclusion. Then another one is statistical physics. What is means this statistics is related to your fundamental theories of physics and use probability theory solving of type of different types of physical problems. Then actuarial science. What is the actuarial science? Means it is a statistical method to assess risk and insurance, that finance industries. This is related to our finance departments. Then one most important topic, one important basic concept of statistics is populations. Actually, what is populations? In statistics, a population include all members of defined group that we studying to डेटा ड्राइव डिसाइजेस मींस द ऑल पॉपुलेशंस या ए ग्रुप ऑफ सैंपल्स व्हिच इज यूज्ड फॉर ए वैलिड कंक्लूजन इन केस ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स दी कॉल्ड एज ए पॉपुलेशंस इन ओपन सपोज समटाइम्स ए गवर्नमेंट विशेस टू ट्राई डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सपोज वी वांट टू टेक डेटा ऑफ जेंडर डेटा ऑफ रेस इनकम डेटा रिलीजन डेटा दिस टाइप ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन गैदर और दिस टाइप्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन गैदरिंग ओवर ए होल पॉपुलेशन दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ए सेंसस तो वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज सब पॉपुलेशन मींस ए सबसेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इज कॉल्ड एज ए सब पॉपुलेशन सपोज व्हाट इज बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ सपोज सब पॉपुलेशन सपोज यू वांट टू कैटेगराइज डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पॉपुलेशन सपोज यू वांट टू इफ यू वांट टू कैलकुलेट डिफरेंट नंबर्स ऑफ पीपल्स इन ए पर्टिकुलर एरिया देन यू कैटेगराइज टू कैटेगरी वन इज मेल अनदर फीमेल data of male and data of female means this is a subpopulations one population is total number of peoples but is divided in two types one is two subpopulation one is male population another is female population so this is a subdivisions of a populations means you can say this is a subset of a populations then when we hear word of population then we typically thinks of means it means a living populations this is already covering previous topic so okay what is the examples if you interested to making generalizations about the crows suppose if you want to a populations of a crows then what is the accuracy of them then a statistical population it is set of all crows that exist now jo abhi present question mein hai then the statistical population is a set of crows that is exist now and ever existed or will exist in future since means dekhiye this is a present population so we are present number of the crows then in case of future what are in the case of the future existing which type of how many type of crows and in case of ever existed means past mein kitna wo log exist kiya hai then sub population sub already described about sub population means a subset of population called is a subpopulation different in this type population similarly we can often estimate parameters more accurately if one separate out subpopulations for example the distributions of height among people is better modeled by considering men and women as a separate by populations so most important is experimental planning dekhiye there are 9 steps there are 9 this is a flow chart of experimental project so before we planning our experiment we should always take in your mind ki what are the experimental what are the basic things in case of experimental planning first is determine the need for the experiment ki how much we can need do you really need the experiment yeah what are the type of the need what are the needs first is the perform of when you are preparing to initiate the experimental program be sure the following questions should be keep in your mind what type of questions first why perform the experiment ki hum experiment kyu kar rahe hain first question apne mind mein hona chahiye ki why perform the experiment second can the information you are seeking be found elsewhere such as any literature such as any journal such as any books such as any project ki jo bhi hum kaam kar rahe hain kya wo already kahin se cut copy paste to nahi hai means this should be plagiarism free then another question should be have sufficient time dekhi agar hum apne mind mein setup karna chahiye ki apne jo program kar rahe hain iske liye apne paas sufficient time hai ki nahi पता पड़े हमने 3 साल का प्रोग्राम ले लिया और अपने पास समय है सिर्फ 1 महीने का तो व्हाट इज पॉसिबल या व्हाट इज पॉसिबल सो हैव अ सफिशिएंट टाइम एंड मनी बजट आल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट प्ले रोल इन योर रिसर्च प्रोग्राम कि आपका मनी बजट उस लेवल में है या नहीं आर यू रेस्ट्रिक्टेड टू स्पेसिफिक मटेरियल और इक्विपमेंट बिफोर यू स्टार्टिंग योर एक्सपेरिमेंट यू आर क्लियरली कि यू हैव एनी स्पेसिफिक लैब yeah you have any type of materials present here no then another is define objective for experiment ki apne ko sure ho jana chahiye ki what type of objective we will take suppose Always prepare a list of all things which you want to carry out. Means always keep in your mind following points ki what should be what questions regarding your problem ki aapki problems ke kis type ke questions ho sakte hain. These are objectives. Then are you sure you are not losing sight on your overall objectives? Ya possible alternative solutions? Ya can't see forest for trees like see a tree likes you can receive this objective. Suppose you want to carry out your research in different locations. Suppose you want to take your one locations, yeah, one environment in Purnia, and you want to take your another experiment into Patna. So always take in your mind ki what are the experimental objective? Can we define this type of locations? Can we take yeah specific answers of these questions will be related to our experimental. So these are the objective. Means the objective must be clear. What type of objective you want to take in at the time of experimental? Yeah, at the time of experimental carried out, yeah, experimental finding. Then another is choose responses you want to measure. कि आपको किस टाइप का responses चाहिए थी. Means the there are generally two different type of variables. You know very well. There are two types of variable. Which types of variable? One is dependent variable. Another is independent variable. So what is the what are the key? At the time as a experimental program is a design, the important dependent variable to be measured must be identified. जो जो variable है वो must be identified होनी चाहिए. और इसमें कौन-कौन से questions आपके mind में रहेंगे उस time पे? What are the controlled or independent variable? अगर आप कोई एक्सपेरिमेंट कर रहे हैं तो आपके माइंड में होना चाहिए कि उस एक्सपेरिमेंट से रिलेटेड इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल कौन से हैं. इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स मींस द वेरिएबल्स दैट आर नॉट कंट्रोल्ड. और देन अनदर इज व्हाट आर द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स मींस इन दैट कंडीशन व्हिच टाइप ऑफ डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल आर प्रेजेंट. आर इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स और टेक्निक्स अवेलेबल टू मेक द measurements, there are various type of techniques are present. Yeah, will the accuracy of the expected result be sufficient? Always keep in your mind, if you are try to take your result, yeah, you will try to your experiment, then always thinks, will the accuracy of expected result be sufficient? Ki aap jo field mein kar rahe hain ya jo bhi aap experiment kar rahe hain uski accuracy sufficient hai. Means this should be identify. Means dekhi, there are simple things. There are two variable. One is dependent variable, another is independent variable. What is independent variable? Just like an independent variable, a dependent variable is exactly what it sound like. It is something that depend on your other factors. For example, देखिए होता क्या है dependent variable क्या है. देखिए मैं example बताता हूँ. What is dependent? For example, a test score could be dependent variable. जैसे आप कोई एग्जाम देते हैं तो उसका स्कोर कार्ड क्या है आपका डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल बिकॉज इट कुड बी चेंज डिपेंडिंग ऑन सेवरल फैक्टर सच एज हाउ मच यू स्टडी आपने कितनी पढ़ाई की है आपको उतने ही मार्क्स मिलेंगे. मीन्स दिस इज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. हाउ मच स्लीप आप उस टाइम पे कितना सोए हैं तो इसका मतलब कम मार्क्स मिलेंगे. यू गोट राइट बिफोर यू कैन टुक टेस्ट मीन्स आपने जितना देखिए सिंपल चीज है डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल मतलब जैसे आपने कोई एग्जाम दी उसका कितने मार्क्स आएगा वो किस पे डिपेंड करता है कि आपने कितनी पढ़ाई की है उससे रिलेटेड कितने रिव्यू लिटरेचर पढ़े हैं आपने कितना डीप में गए हैं या आप कितना सोए हैं या आप कितना टाइम पास किए हैं. दिस ऑल वेरिएबल्स आर कंसिडर इन डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल मीन्स दिस इज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट एग्जाम्पल इज इनडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. वाट इज इनडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल? इनडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल मीन्स दिस वेरिएबल is not controlled. Yeah, we can say this is a not controlled variation. इसको आप control नहीं कर सकते. Suppose the age of human being. आप जैसे आदमी की age है उसको आप रोक नहीं सकते. This is a independent. आप ऐसा नहीं कर सकते जैसे आज 50 के हैं कल हम 10 के हो जाएं. So it is not possible. This is a independent variable. Or suppose this is a color of skin. It is also a independent variable. But it may be dependent if you use a lot of hair lovely, a lot of face mask, a lot of different types of lighting creams. So you can definitely say डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल या यू कैन से द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल मे बी डिपेंडेंट। कैसे? जैसे हमने बोला है कि स्किन कलर आपका कैसा है, ब्लैक है, आप यूज कर रहे हैं फेयर एंड लवली, आप यूज कर रहे हैं दूसरी कोई कॉस्मेटिक प्रोडक्ट, तो आपका कलर में स्लाइटली चेंज हो रहा है, तो इट मे बी डिपेंडेंट, बट जनरली क्लाइमेटिक ऑल क्लाइमेटिक फैक्टर्स या ऑल क्लाइमेटिक वेरिएबल्स आर इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स। ओके, तो दीज आर द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट वेरिएबल्स। देन मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट फिफ्थ पॉइंट इज योर डिजाइन ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट। व्हाट इज द डिजाइन ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट, यू कैन से एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन। एक्चुअली होता है क्या, एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन हमने प्रीवियस टॉपिक में डिटेल से बताया था, थोड़ा इंग्लिश बोल दी थी इसलिए हम हिंदी में बता रहा हूँ थोड़ा, कि इन केस ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन, व्हाट इज एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन। एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन मीन्स अरेंजमेंट ऑफ ए प्लॉट फॉर ए पर्टिकुलर साइट ऑफ ए एक्सपेरिमेंटल साइट। एक्सपेरिमेंटल साइट्स में जो आप प्लॉट्स लेते हैं उनका अरेंजमेंट ही एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन होता है। यू नो वेरी वेल एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिजाइन आर व्हाट आर द प्रिंसिपल्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई जस्ट ब्रीफ अबाउट द सेम, देयर आर थ्री पार्ट, देयर आर थ्री बेसिक प्रिंसिपल, replication, randomization and local control. What is replication? Means repetitions of a control. Then randomization. Randomization means random allocations of a treatment is called as a randomization. How we can randomize allocate the treatment? This is a randomization. Then local control. Local control means error control. देखिए आप error control को कैसे कम कर सकते हैं? एक simple thing है. If you want to take any type of experiment, then firstly you should your mind, your field should be homogeneous. Always your never be homogeneous. First you should try to homogeneous. Suppose you want to take your experiment. Suppose you have different types of treatments. Suppose you have a 40 treatments. The different 40 treatments are allocated in a single blocks. Means blocking. By using of blocking, you are reduce the experimental error. Means how you can blocking the your experiment. Suppose different type of replications, then random allocation treatment means randomizes. These are the basic principle which is used for the reductions of your experimental risks. So this is complete. Then the experimental design having different types of designs, we know very well factorial design and two factorial, this is already covered. Okay, then sixth point is perform experiment. Ki how we perform your experiment. Suppose at the time of your experiment, then the most important is performance of your experiment. देखिए performance experiment का मतलब क्या, suppose आपने अपना, suppose you take your experiment, then what are the performance? So which type of performance, suppose design of experiment we will vary with. So different types of error are considered at this time. So what are the types of error? Generally there are two types of error that should be avoided in experimental designs. A type first error is one of which you clear that variable has effect on the experimental outcomes when it is and real effect. And type second error result is lost informations, means a variable gets incorrectly classified as a insignificant to process of ignored. जो ignore कर रहे हैं वो insignificant है. And the result and no further examination is take place. There is no need to take. But in case of type second error can be avoided by researching fundamental principles. What are the fundamental principles of experimental? Replication, randomization, then local control. Yeah, we can say this is a error control. So these types of related to perform your experiment. Ki how you perform your experiment. Then the minimizing number of experiment, how we can minimize your result, yeah, how you can minimize your number of experiment. So the minimum number of experiment that must be performed is related to number of important independent variable. Always remember, means this is must be performed related to number of important independent variables. Okay, so these are the depend these are the related to perform experiment. Then last is analyze results. Suppose your experiment is conducted, you find a valid conclusion, you find a different types of data, then how you can correlate it, then how you can actually hota kya, actually the result performing the experimental, how many times if there is some error associated with measuring the outcome of your experiment, we must consider repetition of the sum statements. देखिए ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस रिपीटेशन मीन्स ब्लॉकिंग. अगर अपने को उसकी एक्सपेरिमेंटल एरर कम करना है, रिजल्ट अपने को एक्यूरेस पाना है, एनालाइज द रिजल्ट्स. बिफोर एनालाइज रिजल्ट्स द आउटकम ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट मस्ट बी कंसिडर रिपीटेड समटाइम्स ऑफ द ट्रायल में बी श्योर. किस टाइप का प्रॉब्लम वी हैव एक्यूरेट इंफॉर्मेशन बट हाउ मच डाटा इज इनफ. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल की हाउ मच डाटा you are take for your analysis of the result. Means how good are the measurements, which types of, what are the modifications you can need, then if any types of existing equipment are necessary, then improve the accuracy or provisions of the same thing. So we can say there are type of different reactions, different types of small, different types of outcomes. So dekhiye what kinds of, suppose we take a experiment, after taking experiment, our experiment is, suppose we use different two locations, three locations or four locations. After taking these data from different locations, we should try to result. This type of result, suppose we get results for disease resistance. Suppose we result for two abiotic states. Suppose we get result for different type of diversity. Suppose you take for any types of zinc iron content in any crops. So these are the data, and these data must be analyzed with the using of different types of statistical. Suppose you want to identify different QTLs for a particular disease. Agar aapko QTL, actually what is QTL? Ye ek scientific term hai, only science wale samajh payenge. QTLs means a region, which is a particular region which govern any character. Here we can say, देखिए, it may be a group of genes, or it may be QTL. QTL what is? QTL means a locus of particular locus of a DNA, a particular locus of a gene. It may be a group of genes, it may be a single gene, it may be a few of genes. So suppose you want to identify one different QTL for a particular disease. So what are the analysis? How we can analyze this? Suppose we have two type of data. Suppose we have genotypic data, suppose we have phenotypic data. So these two data, after using a particular software, suppose different type of software available in market, these software are combinedly used, then we get a valid results. So these are the analysis of the results. Another is act of results. Dekhiye, after getting a result, then how we interpret your data, how you interpretations of the data, it is a most important. Suppose you get your data different, suppose you are having disease data, suppose you have in plant data, suppose you have qualitative data, suppose you have physical data, suppose you have genotypic data. These all data, after analyzing, and we form out different types of graphs, different types of tables. So these tables and graphs are interpreted correlation to each other, yeah, correlated to each other. So these types should be, yeah, these shall be important for the interpretations of the data. Ki how we can present your research. So this is a, then last is report. Dekhiye report kya, jaise aapne pura apna research, suppose you are finished your work, then lastly you should be write a report. This report also called as a thesis, yeah, also called as a your thesis writing, yeah, your called a project report. Dekhiye most important things is, typical a report will be include the following sections. So what type of section include in your report? First is abstract. What is abstract? This is one page summary of a experiment. Means the your outcomes should be taken in abstract. Means this is one page summary of the experiment. This is first one. Then second is introduction. What is introduction? Introduction means the section define problems. Ki which type of problems, what type of objective you are taken on, and which types of fundamental issues and discusses of analysis, yeah, how they related to published works in this same area. Then third is review of literature. What is review of literature? It is a comprehensive summary of previously research on same topic. Suppose जैसे आपने ये work कर लिया है, आप ये work करना चाहते हैं in the future, इस work को रेफरेंस आप किससे मिलेगा? रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर. इसी काम को पहले कौन कौन कर चुका है, इसलिए दिस थर्ड पॉइंट इज रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर. देन थर्ड इज, फोर्थ इज मटेरियल्स एंड मेथड्स. at the time of your experiment, you should take these types of material. This means this section describes the equipment used to carry out the experiment as well as the instruments, which types of methods you want to take at the time of your experimental conditions, experimental field carried out. Means fifth is results. Results is also called as the experimental finding. Means this section, which types of findings are concluded. Then discussion. Discussion means this section tells why the results look way to do. Means how we can discuss by previously किसने किया है उसको कैसे हम discuss कर रहे हैं. This is a discussion portion. Then summary and conclusion. The summary and conclusion section lists the all important informations you learned for this work. कि आपने इसमें क्या-क्या सीखा. ये आपका और references. References means the bibliography of the results. These are the references and lastly thank you.